It's exceedingly rare to speak to somebody in North Korea's inner circle because officials here have an intense distrust of the Western media and they rarely grant interviews. But we sat down with the deputy director of a North Korean think tank with close ties to the highest levels of government, and no topic was off limits. We asked about the North Korean nuclear program, whether the reports leaked by the Wall Street Journal are true that the country has 20 nuclear devices and the ability to perhaps double that number in the very near future. He said that North Korea does have nuclear weapons, though he wouldn't confirm any numbers. He also said this country has a long-range ballistic missile capable of reaching the United States. We also asked about those reports that have been out now for a while, accusing the supreme leader here of essentially getting rid of anyone who disagrees with him.
South Korea's National Intelligence Service alleged that the Marshal Kim Jong-un ordered 15 executions of officials this year.
The report itself is malicious slander against the DPRK, especially because they tried to link the alleged statements to the august name of our supreme leader, Marshal Kim Jong-un. I would say that any country might have anti-government hostile elements who are trying to overthrow their government or trying to subvert the system. So it's very normal for any country to go after those hostile elements and punish them and execute them.
But he also called those allegations against Kim Jong-un groundless and baseless. When we asked about the United Nations human rights report alleging widespread abuse of prisoners in a network of prison camps, he denied flat out the existence of political prison camps, saying there's no political strife here and therefore no political prisoners, although he did acknowledge that, of course, there are prisons here just like anywhere else. And when he talked about the future of North Korea, he said the government's main focus now is to improve the economy, which continues to struggle because of international sanctions. However, that may be difficult with mutual distrust with the West and, of course, that refusal to disarm the nuclear arsenal. Will Ripley, CNN, Pyongyang, North Korea.